You can see this is the final table what we got. So we are going to sum up all the columns what we are having, including the fixed end moments what we received at the supports or joints. So you can see that the summation of all the moments are coming out to be zero. That is, the joint is now neutralized. Coming on to the C joint, we are having the summation of all the moments coming out to be minus 40. So the applied moment was anti-clockwise 40, so it is coming out to be minus 40. And these are the moments which are coming on to DEF. How we are doing this and how we are getting these moments, check out in the full video. Hello all, this is Smriti Gupta and you are watching Simple Civil with me. We are here with another video, and in this video we are going to solve this question with the moment distribution method. And this question has already occurred in KTU Kerala Technical University 2013 scheme. So we are going to solve this question using moment distribution diagram. Stick with me and we'll be solving this question together. So in this question, sabse pehle, number one step, we are having fixed end moments. So fixed end moments, you can see there are two kinds of loading in this. One is your UDL and one is your triangular loading. So the formula what we are using here is this one. So your clockwise we are taking as negative and anti-clockwise we are taking as positive. These are the sign conventions what we are using. So this is your notations ABCD, the joint names, and now we are going to find out all the fixed end moments here. So fixed end moments for ABBCCD would be same because they are having the same kind of loading, and EI is also same for these members. So we are going to write positive negative. So we are having clockwise as negative. So your right side is negative, left side we are considering as positive. Why we are considering positive negative, you can check in my other videos. So on this leg there is no load, so we are putting that equal to zero. I am putting a dash, so that dash is your fixed end moments. And this one will be using this formula, and we are just going to substitute the value of W and L here, and we are going to substitute these values in the calculator, and we are having this final answers with us. Our next step is step number two, that is finding out rotation factor and distribution factor. For that you have to make this table. Number one, you have to identify the joints having more number of members joined to that. That is your B and C. B and C both are having three members attached to that joint. So we are going to write all the members attached to B and C. Always remember, you have to take the members in the same way. So see, I am taking in the anti-clockwise manner. You also take the same so that chances of mistakes are less. So your AB, then BE I have taken, and then BC I have taken. Like that you take. Now next step is finding out the rotation factor. So for rotation factor, the formula what we are using here is, we have a beam like this, fix, and if we apply a moment M at the near end, a moment will be generated at the far end, which is restricting the deflection in the beam. The amount of moment is 4EI by L. For hinge, it is 3EI by L. We'll be using this formula and substituting the values in all the members. So your BA, BE, BC, you have to be careful with what formula you are substituting. So only CB will be having 3EI by L. Rest all are fixed, so we'll be using 4EI by L. Now what I am doing is, here only I am writing the length and the rigidity value so that chances of mistakes are less while substituting. Most of the students, what they do mistake is they overlook the rigidity. They either substitute everything as I or everything as 2I. So length problem is also there and rigidity problem is also there with the students. So what you have to do, be very careful. So here I am substituting all the values in the formula here. Here we are, we have substituted all the values in the formula, and simply we are going to all the values in the calculator and simply you have to calculate. Now sum, you have to just sum up all the RF given in the column. So at B and C respectively, you have to calculate and write it down. DF is your sum, your RF upon the sum. So RF upon the sum, you have to remember that the sum of DF at a joint has to be equal to 1. And if it is not coming out to be 1 or less or more, you have to adjust the decimals in the same way. So now we are coming on to the final table of the moment distribution diagram. So here I am preparing one. Few people, what they do, the members, wherever they are in the frame, they put the DF there and then put the FEM and then start to do. I'll do it like this because I find it easy. Here only at B and C, I am marking the leg which is vertical so that we should know that where we have to transfer our moment and where we don't have to transfer our moment. So here I am writing all the DF what we have calculated. So if you are writing it in the order, so you can write it like that without making any mistake. So just simply write it without any mistake, because students make mistake is they write DF of another member in another member. So you need to check it and write it in the same format what it is. So here we have BA, BE and BC. So in the same format I have written, so like that I can write. Here we are with all the values of DF. Next step is we'll be writing down all the FEM what we have calculated. Write down all the figs and moments what we got from the previous page. So here we have D as hinged. So what happens at the hinge? Hinge moments are always zero. So what we'll be doing, we are going to make whatever fixed end moments came, we have to make it zero. So what I am doing, opposite sign, same moment, and half of it will be transferred to the far end. So here we are. And at C joint, what I am doing, I am adding all the moments. So positive 25 is coming. And our anti-clockwise moment which is applied at C is also positive. So these two get added. So 65 came. Same at B, what I have done is, I have added all the moments which are there. So unbalanced moment at B is your 13.33. So this is positive, what I am doing, I am putting a negative sign here. So negative sign, RF multiplied by the unbalanced moment, and you have to write it down. So your unbalanced moment into RF will give you this much. Here unbalanced moments are 65 positive. So I am writing negative negative, then RF multiplied by the unbalanced moment. Next step is you have to transfer it to the fixed end. So whatever fixed ends are there, you have to transfer it to the far end. So B will be transferring to A joint. B will be transferring to E joint and B will be transferring to C joint. So here we are. So we'll be transferring it. And now C will be transferring to only F and B joint. No transfers will be made on D because it is a hinged joint. So on hinged, no transfers are made. Unbalanced moment divided by 2 with the sign. So we have to do the transfer or carryover, which is unbalanced moment divided by 2 with the sign. Check the nature of the unbalanced moment. Put opposite sign. If it is negative, you have to put positive. So I am putting positive multiplied by DF and write it there. Opposite sign multiplied by DF and write it there. So we have to do this procedure at least till 4 iterations or 4 cycles. So what we have to do is opposite sign multiplied by the DF and we have to write it. Again we'll be doing the carryover or transfer of the unbalanced moment. So how we are doing it? Same what we have done last time. So B will be transferring it to A, B will be transferring it to the C, and B will be transferring to E, and the E I have written on the right side. So here we are writing all the unbalanced moment. Again whatever imbalance moment came at B and C, we have to balance it. So opposite sign, first we have to put the opposite sign. So this is positive, I am putting negative here, this is positive. Negative, negative, I am putting, just multiplied with the DF, excuse me, just multiplied with the DF, and we have to write it down. Here we are, and we are writing all the unbalanced moment here, and we are balancing it and writing. Then next step is we are carry over or transferring half of it to the far end, half of it to the far end, only at the fixed support. Nothing will go to the hinge. Hinge, they will give you only once and they will not receive anything from you. So we are transferring all the moments here. The next step is, again we have to balance it. So next step will be balancing. So whatever sign, so here it is negative. So we have to write opposite sign and multiplied with the DF, and we have to write down. So we have already done with the four iterations. Now we'll be checking that at one joint, the total amount of moment is coming out to be in equilibrium or not. That is, the total sum of all the moments are cancelling out each other and your support is in equilibrium. So here we are at B support, the sum of all the moments are coming out to be zero. At C joint, as you can see there is an anti-clockwise moment at the C support, so the sum of all the moments coming on to this has to be equal and opposite, so it is coming out to be minus 40, which is balancing all the moments coming on to the joint. Next, we have to sum all the moments including the FEM. So at D it will be zero, and here we are completed with all the moments. So we have already discussed that at C it has to be equal and opposite, at B it has to be zero, and we have to sum up all. Please subscribe if you like it.